Necklace has a harper sigil. Why were they here?
Might be worth a look.
At the back of the crevice lies a bag enfolded in the chitinous squabbling of spiders. A shiny gold coin pokes from its mouth. Creatures clutch the pouch possessively. Is gold so precious to spiders? The spiders scatter, and you stash the bag. Something clinks among the coins.
Shadow. Such a grim name for such a beautiful flower.
Could you not stare so blatantly in my neck when you say that, please?
Oh, but do keep calling her flower. She'll love that. nothing.
Unless you like trash.
Look in. Old woman you meet.
Just tell us where she is. We don't want any trouble.
But you're bloody getting something.
Lads, for the love of all that is holy, I've never clapped eyes on your poor sister.
Drop the act, hag. You was the last to see me, Rena.
Just let her go. Please.
Thank goodness you're here, sweetie. I don't know what's come over these boys.
Stop this! We won't ask again!
Sweetie, be careful!
She's with the hag!
Don't bloody stand there gaping! Get her!
For this to happen. Those poor boys were looking for their little sister, Mayrina, the girl who's staying with me. This is all my fault, but I made a promise. Mayrina begged me not to breathe a word if they came looking for her, and my word is my bond. That poor thing will be distraught. We can't let her know it'd break her poor heart. I'd best get going, but please stop by my house. I'd like to thank you proper.
Helpless old ladies. Was that normal?
Chill runs up your spine. You feel like you're being watched. The place has a quiet sense of calm. You can't see anything strange.
Watch how you go. There's a trap.
cautious.
Someone doesn't like visitors.
The gods are watching me.
Traps. How considerate.
Something's wrong. I feel... Ah, it hurts. Darkness, protect me. No. I'm fine. Forget it.
You know, I was just thinking about you, remembering our little encounter in the night. And I am very grateful. It did get me thinking about the others, though, how they might taste. And not that anyone's volunteered, it's just an idle fancy. That's the thing. I can't quite figure them out. Take Gale, for example. He strikes me as someone whose blood is rich, refined, like well-aged brandy. But the Gith, what in the hells would she taste like? Sounds very appealing. I'm almost convinced. Absolutely. A mere thought experiment. So, In the spirit of theoretical questions, if you had to take a bite from one of them, who would it be? Ah, a refined palate. I can't disagree. Although, the more I think on it, the hungrier I get. I better go find something I can actually get my teeth into. There's nothing that tasty lurking out in the woods, but I'll make do. Sweet dreams.
A tingle runs through your head and down to your feet.
Ah, there it is. That shiver. Our little brainworms have made fast friends, it would seem. How do you feel? Courage in danger, Shadow. I love to see it. But shouldn't the Shadow have crept closer? Gone darker by now? Before the Illithid's unscheduled surgery, I'd felled hundreds of beasts and a fair few fiends. The tadpoles weakened me, suppressed greater talents, but beyond that, I've showed no signs of turning. No nausea, no pain, not even a hot flash. Indeed. Perhaps the worm's vat was poisoned. Perhaps we're uncommonly fit. Or perhaps the tadpoles are merely on holiday. We could conjecture all night. I suppose the why doesn't matter so much as the what next. And that answer is plain as the horns on a war devil's head. We get these things out. Let's get some rest. Dawn comes sooner than we think.
Do you feel as flattered as I do?
Fight it to dine with a devil.
I've never met a devil, but of course I've read a great deal about them. Even feigning a mortal form, it was easy to detect the whiff of sulfur about him. To spot the flicker of hellfire in his eyes.
Don't let his bluster fool you. All that talk of desperation merely illustrates his own. I think he wants something from us, badly. And in that knowledge lies our opportunity. Our souls. But I suspect that's but his opening offer.
Let me play the devil's advocate. The man is too eager. Do not dismiss his offer out of hand.
If there's one quality all the denizens of the Hells embody, it's ambition. A quality they share with many humans, come to think of it. By figuring out his true intentions. Fact one. There's something very strange and very powerful about our tadpoles. Fact two, a devil offers to take it away. Devils aren't known to aid mortals out of simple kindness. Whatever Raphael wants, we must be the key to getting it, along with our tadpoles. So, we're safe for now. We wait. If I'm right, Raphael will seek us out again, and when he does, there's a mighty bargain to be made. Remember his Cormyrian rhyme? Down came the claw. Perhaps we should start growing our nails.
Devil Raphael flaunts his paltry wings as if he wants to impress us.
You saw the red dragon slaying his infernal kin above Hell's fires, did you not? Next to a dragon, the devil's a gnat. When I am Kithrak, I will take my Queen Vlakith his head as a trophy. Githyanki Knights, the riders that chase the Nautiloid. They are the commissars and enforcers of my Queen Vlakith's will. Vlakith bestows no greater honor. To wield a Kithrak silver sword is my destiny. I will earn my queen's favor, and I will conquer every layer of hell should she command it. The Geich are my kind's mortal enemy. It is not unusual for the Kithrak to give chase, to penetrate the hells. This is unusual. But I'm not one to question the wisdom of my queen. I can see but to the horizon. Vlakith's sight pierces the many plains.
I know that look. You're wondering why I was in pain before. Let's just clear the air about that now. It's just an old wound that hurts me from time to time. Nothing to be concerned about. It's nothing to do with the tadpoles, at least, in case your imagination is in danger of getting away from you. It's just something I have to live with. Quite a lot, if I'm being honest. But it always passes quickly, so I can manage.
Blood everywhere.
someone wasn't as fortunate in their choice of campsite as us.
I wonder what kind of creature could have caused so much damage. Slow down. Thank you.
Thank you.
Fill that one later. Open up.
Sheep's voice warbles. You realize it's trying to say bar. The sheep stands. stares at you with unsettling malice. Wheezing, the sheep backs away. Its entire body shakes. It ribbits erratically as if in pain. It shies away, croaking a warning, eyes wide in terror. It croaks softly, calmed. But the frog's eyes watch your every movement.
Ah, stranger. Forgive the aroma.
You catch a waft of something foul, metallic, and sickly sweet.
Powdered iron vine. An old hunter's trick. Most monsters will think twice before making a meal of me.
You're a monster hunter? I'm surprised. I thought all Ger were vagrant cutthroats.
You should listen to your companion. Next, he'll warn you that my people can curse your cow to give only sour milk,
and will seduce your daughter to a life of roaming. I wish I had half the power settled folk think my people possess. Alas, I am a simple wanderer. A simple wanderer and monster hunter. But I'm no witch doctor or cutthroat. True. And I have no proof to offer but my word. If you wish it, our paths need not cross again. I'm hunting a vampire spawn. And it's a little too bright for you to be my prey. His name is Astarion, but I fear he's gone to ground. I hope the hag of these lands can help me flush him out, if I can afford her blood price. Not this time. My orders are to capture him.
Oh. And bring him where, exactly?
Baldur's Gate. My people wait for me there. Thank you. Treating with a hag. I need all the luck I can get. May your road be kind.
Fresh, sweet-smelling water gurgles gently below. The warm rush of power flows through you. You feel stronger, faster, better.